a quick switch of the head, and now you have the T-800 completely damaged right after he crashes on that pillar there chasing Sarah and Reese. Even the second head sculpt, I mean, and guys, if you're one of the lucky ones that owned the first T-800 figure from Hot Toys, the battle damage one with the outfit when he rides the bike, you should consider yourself very lucky, because now you can exchange this and put it on that sculpt, on that body, sorry. I mean, this is, oh man, even switching to the different look, I mean, now you have Arnold after the whole scene at Tech Noir at the bar. He goes through that, the fire, he goes through the, you know, the car, he gets hit and all that, and you have all his hairs are all cinched up by the fire, and his eyebrows, he doesn't have the eyebrows anymore. He starts to look, he looks pretty beat up. And, man, and his performance in that movie, man, I mean, James Cameron captured the feel of him being a cyborg, a complete dead machine. And this look is here, represented on this figure. This looks so dead, evil, and possessed. The detail on it is spectacular. You can see all the holes on his face, the blood's coming through, and his damaged eye. Do you remember, he gets an X-Acto knife, whatever, and he, like, peels that, oh, man, that eyeball out, and then you can see the T-800 cybernetic eye in there moving. I mean, when I saw that when I was a kid, I was completely shocked. So you get his glance here, his stare. I mean, his eyes are, like, they look so alive. They look so shiny, so glossy. I mean, looks spectacular. And of course, you get the full look of Arnold there. I mean, and the blood dripping down. It looks incredible. Sculpted hair. I mean, look at that. Look at that look there. I mean, it looks real. There's not much I can say. I mean, it looks fantastic. Great work, Hot Toys. I just want to show you quickly the inner shirt. And I mean, the proportions of the figure, of the muscle body. I mean, it looks spectacular, guys. You can barely see the joints here on the muscle. I mean, very well done. I mean, Hot Toys has grown. I mean, they have learned so much throughout all these years sculpting and making figures, and they're getting better and better at sculpting the body proportions, the likeness of the figures. I mean, this looks awesome. Look at how awesome this the body, the proportion of his body here. It looks great. The inner shirt, I mean, awesome detail here. You can see all around here, just like in the movie. I mean, a spectacular detail on this inner shirt and the look and the proportions of the body on Arnold on this figure. Unreal. The weaponry on this figure, it is just awesome. I mean, you can recreate pretty much every scene in that movie and all the weapons he carries in that movie. So here's the pump action shotgun, which looks unbelievable. You know, Hot Toys, they are so well known for their incredible sculpting on their weapons. And I mean, they look so true. I mean, their military line, I said it before, their military line of figures of Hot Toys, they're just untouchable. So here's the shotgun. It looks like a real shotgun reduced to a 1/6 scale. Very awesome detail, but there's no moving parts on this. I thought that you could actually, you know, cock the shotgun, you know, just pump it, but there is absolutely no movement there. But it doesn't really matter. It looks spectacular. This is the 45 long slide with laser sight. Epic scene in that movie when he goes gun shopping and he kills the store seller there. But I mean, look at the level of detail. I mean, the colors, the sculpting on this gun, it is just spectacular. Lots of features too. You get, of course, the slide cocks back. That looks fantastic. The magazine, sorry guys, the magazine comes right out, and you can see the bullets right in there. Very, very, very cool, right there. And then you get the laser sight, which looks like you could. It looks like there's like a little glass there you can actually see through, but you can't. It would have been awesome if it would have had like a light up feature, and you can turn it on, and you can see like a real laser in there. That would have been awesome, but it is. Fantastic. The Uzi 9mm, very, very, oh man, the detail on it is spectacular. The magazine comes right out, very long mag, you can see the bullets in there. Very, very nice, Hot Toys. The cocking about you, this is where you cock the gun, the Uzi, it does not move, which was kind of a bit disappointing. I would like to see that cock back, but oh well, it still looks awesome. It brings this little strap here, so you can attach it to the belt or to these little straps that are inside the coat. But it is cool that it actually comes out, and then you get the stock comes out and it retracts, it folds out, so you can rest it out in your arm. Looks pretty awesome. This is the extra arm you get to perform and to recreate the whole scene after Arnold crashes and he heads to the hotel to repair himself. He's got a lot of damages on his arm, and I mean he gets that X-Acto knife, cuts it open, cuts his skin open, which oh man, it was disgusting back then when I saw it as a kid, and it's disgusting even as today. And, I mean, it looks incredible. You can see all the hydraulic fittings there in there. I mean the blood. I mean the flesh all tore up here. Looks awesome. The blood, and I mean the finger too. I mean the position on it is perfect. You can recreate the scene perfect with his arm. You see the muscle there. Flesh tone looks unbelievable. Here's the adjustable wrench that Arnold uses to perform his repair operation after his the crash. And let me tell you something, guys, that I mean, I am so impressed with the level of detail on this. I thought these would they were made out of plastic, but they're not. I'm not sure if it's metal or I'm not sure yet, but maybe with the help of all the collectors getting this figure, we can find out. But I think they're made out of tin or aluminum, or it could be metal. But 100%, they're not made out of plastic. So this is a great addition to this figure. I mean, the level and attention to detail, it is unbelievable. Fully moving parts here. I mean, as you can see, so small, I can barely handle this in between my fingers. But wow, incredible work, Hot Toys. This is the X-Acto knife that Arnold uses to cut his flesh to perform the repair operation. This is crazy. I mean, look at how small this is. And it's really pointy too. I'm pretty sure if I glide this, and with enough pressure in my skin, I'll probably scratch it or cut it. It is unbelievable the attention to detail that Hot Toys goes through to bring us as much the closer to the movie, and I mean, and important tools to recreate scenes from a movie. Spectacular. And this is not made out of plastic. I think it's made out of metal. Or aluminum, whatever. But it's not made out of plastic. Great work, Hot Toys. Here's a quick size comparison with the previous T2 T800 Arnold figure released earlier this year. And as you can see, they look in perfect scale. And wow, they just look incredible together, guys. It's a must-have for your Terminator collection. My final thoughts on the Terminator T800 1984 once scale figure done by Hot Toys. If you want to celebrate, and if you're looking for a collectible that will blow your mind away, I mean, and to celebrate your Terminator collection, I mean, Terminator 1, the Terminator 1984, was one of the it is one of the most epic movies ever made. James Cameron did such an amazing job with that movie. It'll stay with us for the rest of our lives. Especially, I'm such a huge fan of James Cameron and Arnold. And I'm telling you, when I saw that, I was really young when I saw it. I was completely terrified of this character. But I grew up to love him, and I mean, be such a fan of this series. I wish James Cameron would make more Terminator movies. But the man Arnold has. Not young anymore, and I don't think he will. I mean, it'd be impossible. It'll have to be a CG looking Arnold, like in Salvation. But if you're looking for the ultimate figure to represent this character, this is it right here. Look no further. And this is one of the best, and it's probably the best likenesses to a character ever created in a high-end collectible. The proportion, the body, the tailoring, the paint job, the accuracy to the, I mean, the beautiful material used here on this coat, the attention to detail, recreating the scenes from the movie, which, guys, I am going to get, I do have a 1/6 scale chair ready, and I'm going to get a 1/6 scale table, and I'm going to promise you right now, I will do 2 showcases of this figure and the T2 Arnold. I promise you that. I will get to that, and during the holidays, I'm going to have a lot of time off. But I'm going to do 2 showcases showing you how amazing this figure is going to look, and I'm going to recreate the whole scene, him performing the operation. I know it's not in this video, but I just wanted to show you the figure and everything it brings, and it just, oh man, this looks incredible. So you will be completely blown away when you get this in your house and you see it face to face. It is worth every penny, and I mean, that's all I can say. And there's absolutely, there, you know, on the positive side, negative side, there's everything is positive on this. There is nothing negative about this figure. This is probably the best high-end collectible of 2010. I hope you guys enjoyed my review of this exciting figure. Oh man, I am still blown away by this. This looks incredible. Look at the look on this face. Evil, pure evil, dead cyborg there coming at you. And target you. Don't be target for termination, because he'll come and get you, man. That it looks incredible. This figure looks possessed. You guys take it easy. Stay tuned. I have the Mark IV Hot Toys review coming soon from Iron Man 2. It should be here next week. Maybe I'll do it for the holidays. And let me wish you a Merry Christmas. We're only 1 week away. But I will do a video, you know, I'm going to do a wish, Happy New, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year video real soon. And stay tuned for more updates on high-end collectibles from Hot Toys, Sideshow Collectibles, Kotobukiya, and everybody. You guys take it easy. Have a great day. And remember, collectors unite.